But something is still worrying me. Our Titans, our Asian Marauder ants, have disappeared from sight yet again. The last time they disappeared, we happened to find them in pretty impressive numbers after pulling out some wheat. But since then, their disappearance has been very unsettling to me. I see wandering black crazy ants inside, but no Titans. Are the Titans still alive? There was only one way to find out.
Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy!
I can't believe it's come to this. I had to know. All I needed to see was even a few workers from a scoop of soil within the Garden of Eden. This terrarium home to our Titans, who needless to say, have gone through a lot over the past several months since moving in here. AC family, believe me when I say this, you will want to keep on watching until the end. This Garden of Eden series has been called the Dragon's Curse Saga, because it has all been quite a twisted and eerie tale I've never before experienced in all my years of ant-keeping. There were signs that this terrarium was cursed. Perhaps by the great bearded dragon who had inhabited these lands in the Garden of Eden's prehistoric times, but died earlier last year. It seemed the dragon's spirit lingered as we attempted to recultivate it into a land to house our ants. You, the AC family, voted for the Jawbreakers, our trap jaw ants, to move in. But before that could happen, a colony of wild black crazy ants broke into the Jawbreaker setup and extinguished our Jawbreakers. We then decided to move in our Titans, our majestically polymorphic marauder ants. Once inside, the colony's health immediately began to show signs of fading, and we thought they had all died out. We then tried to move in our dark knights, our black crazy ants, who immediately broke out of the setup, so we had to literally vacuum them out and place them back into their original setup. We received a ray of hope one day when we discovered that the Titans were actually still alive. But that was short-lived when literally out of the soils appeared an ant baby-eating, self-cloning snake, which we managed to collect but died before we could do anything with it. The Titans disappeared once again, but thankfully resurfaced again. And just when we thought it was all over, a colony of black crazy ants and wild pharaoh ants broke into the Garden of Eden and invaded Titan's lands. We captured the pharaoh ants to keep as pets, but they ended up mysteriously contracting mites, which immediately ended our journey with them. And as for the black crazy ants, they still actively frequent Garden of Eden lands, seemingly ruling it now. Isn't this all just one huge crazy story? I cannot believe everything that has happened. Which brings us to this ultimate moment. After the Titans' third disappearance for weeks from sight, it was time to truly take matters into our own hands and get to the bottom of this Dragon's Curse saga, literally. It was time to dig out the Garden of Eden and see if our Titans were simply growing their numbers underground or had truly died. Like an aggravated tempest, I tore and ripped away at the vegetation of the Garden of Eden, which once used to sit so pristine and beautiful. Now, it was like a thick, impenetrable blanket, hiding the truth of the darkness that lay within. I saw nothing so far. Clearing away some of the brush, I immediately spotted some wild crazy ants within one of the driftwood pieces. It was where they had set up camp. They scrambled and carried their brood in a panic. I had to keep going. We needed our Titans to survive. I moved earth and tried my best to dig at the surface. All I wanted to see were some Titan workers. Perhaps hit a vein of their underground network was all I needed to stop. I saw nothing of this. I removed the first piece of driftwood. There was nothing under it. No Titans. Just lots of wild black crazy ants scrambling for their lives. I removed the second piece of driftwood. Nothing still. I began to dig at the earth, turning up the soils. All I could see were earthworms. Earthworms everywhere. They had done a great job at keeping the soils conditioned. My wish was that the Titans were as thriving and successful somewhere below. As I continued to dig away, I had to make sure I was careful not to dig too deep or too forcefully in hopes to not injure the queen. If I accidentally split the queen in half during this major excavation, the colony, if alive, would definitely be irrevocably doomed. Again, all I saw were earthworms. I removed the piece of driftwood and dug away at the earth to find signs of Titan life. Wild black crazy ants scrambled about, as well as various tiny creatures like springtails and snails. But no Titans. And then I saw it. I was shocked, AC family. Look at what I found laying in the upturned soil. It was... a decapitated Titan head. I wasn't sure if it was the head of a super major or that of our Titan's queen. My heart sank. We had to keep looking. Let's keep hopeful, AC family. There was still a chance our Titans were hiding in a subterranean refuge somewhere in here. I dug deep into the first corner, the second corner, the third corner, and fourth corner. After literally 2 hours of digging, I found remains of our Titans. And sadly, it looked like the gaster segments of Her Royal Highness, the Titan's queen. My worst fears were confirmed. I'm afraid, AC family, our Titans are gone. I checked everywhere. The Garden of Eden, which used to be a beautiful sanctuary for creatures and our ants, was now an upturned and devastated land of wreckage. I'm sorry, AC family. I am deeply saddened by this loss of our Titans. Marauder ants, known scientifically as Carabera diversa, though an impressive species, have been known to be extremely difficult to keep in captivity. But I didn't want to make that an excuse. I did my best to keep them alive and happy by providing them with all the resources and space they needed to thrive. But this succession of just so many endangering events befell them that they failed to prevail. It was an amazing journey keeping these ants for the 8 months that they were with us, but as is true in nature, only the strongest live on. It ensures the vitality of all living things on the planet, as only the best genetic combinations get passed on to the next generation, driving evolution forward and keeping life resilient. I try to document on this channel the real and epic lives of ants as they unfold in front of our eyes in our ant room. And sadly, sometimes that does mean death. May the Titans, our Asian Marauder ants, rest in peace. And hopefully as well to the dragon spirit and the conclusion to this curse. AC family, we have finally come to the end of this epic ant story. In order that we may start a new one. AC family, welcome. to Eldragon Island. Oh my, AC family, who would have ever thought keeping and watching ants would be such an emotional roller coaster? Tune in to next week's huge episode when I show this new paludarium, a half terrarium, half aquarium setup, for which so many of you have been requesting forever, specially designed for our new yet unnamed Polyrhachis colony from last week's video. If you're into aquatics, you won't want to miss next week's episode. Plus, I got an official species and biology profile on our new Polyrhachis ants. And AC family, I know you will be thrilled. You won't want to miss it, so do remember to subscribe if you haven't yet, and join the AC family. And hit that like button every time. Even now, AC Inner Colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch a tribute video to our Titans. Before I proceed to the AC question of the week, in case you haven't watched our past few videos, I wanted to quickly plug my new daily vlogging channel. Yes, that's a new video every day, for those of you who may be curious as to what I work on between these weekly ant videos. If you assumed I was just some ant-keeping geek keeping ants in his condo, yes, you're absolutely correct, but you might be surprised to see what you find on my vlogging channel. Thanks to all AC family who have already subscribed, it means a lot to me. Alright, and now it's time for the AC question of the week! Last week we asked, what evidence did we see that show ants take gulps when they drink? Congratulations to Evan Cisneros, who correctly answered, the drop of honey was pulsating. Congratulations, Evan Cisneros, you won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, name any of the creatures we found while digging into the Garden of Eden. Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's Ant Love Forever.